we write down next. One more compound we have. First one I write down aluminium chloride, KLCl3. Two compounds we have to discuss, alum and aluminium chloride. Aluminium chloride, write down. It is obtained from the reaction of dry HCl, AlCl3, dry HCl or chlorine gas with aluminium in the absence of air. I mean, there is no moisture, no H2S. So Al plus aluminium, Al plus 6 HCl, it forms AlCl3 plus H2 gas. Similarly, aluminium with chlorine gas forms AlCl3. AlCl3. Okay. Write on next slide. Hydrated aluminium chloride is obtained by dissolving aluminium metal or aluminium hydroxide. Or aluminium hydroxide in dilute HCl. So Al, this HCl here, it is dry with dilute HCl, it forms hydrated aluminium chloride, AlCl3, and H2O molecule present around this. Okay, so that is hydrated form of this. Even if you take aluminium or AlOH whole thrice with HCl, diluted HCl, it again gives you the same product, that is hydrated AlCl3. Hydrated AlCl3 generally will write AlCl3 dot 6H2O. This is hydrated aluminium chloride, AlCl3 dot 6H2O. Okay. Dilute means what? Water is present. Actually, this is again a coordination compound. Okay, it's the actual structure. I think will be like this. H2O behaves as a ligand. It will be 6 and Cl3 will be outside. Okay, write this molecule. Okay, but this you don't write now. We'll discuss this in coordination compound and understand. Okay. Depending upon this coordination number only, we'll have the number of water molecule present here. Like coordination number of AlH2O whole 6 is 6 there, because aluminium attached with 6 water molecules. So coordination number is 6. So depending upon the coordination number, we'll have the number of water molecule present. Right? What is coordination number and all? In detail we'll discuss that in coordination number. Okay. Next you write down, it is used as a catalyst in Friedel-Crafts reaction. What is Friedel-Crafts reaction? Alkylation and acylation. What is the reaction?
Benzene
plus RX gives benzene and R attached. Okay, in presence of anhydrous
AlCl3.
And another one is acyl group. See, alkylation is what? It is the reaction of alkyl halide with benzene. Acylation is reaction of acyl group with benzene. RCOX with benzene. This is acyl group. This is called AC. So acylation is, acylation is this. Alkyl. we'll just we'll be recording aromatic chemistry class. Okay, let's write down. Write down it reacts with NH4OH and forms a white precipitate of white precipitate of AlOH whole thrice. It reacts with NH4OH and forms white precipitate of AlOH whole thrice. So in reaction, write down AlCl3. Okay, so what is the reaction here? AlCl3 with NH4OH gives AlOH whole thrice plus NH4Cl. Okay, so white precipitate of aluminium hydroxide it forms. Okay, next reaction you write down. Next compound, it is Alum. Alum, the formula is K2SO4 dot Al2SO4 whole thrice hydrated form, it is dot 24H2. Alum is a general form, general name of this. This is potassium and aluminium salt.
So would you call this an adduct, like a coordination?
No, it's not an adduct. It's a hydrated compound of the salt of potassium and aluminium. Okay? When you dissolve this in water, it converts into K plus, Al3 plus, SO4, 2 minus and water molecule. Okay. In this write down, its structure is like, it is a double salt actually. Like NaCl ka structure kya hota hai? We'll see that in crystal, right? So it's a double salt. In this we have K plus ion present, Al3 plus ion present and sulfate salt. It's the crystallized structure, a quaternion compound. It is not a quaternion compound, it's a double salt.
So the K part and the Al part are bonded together.
So K2SO4 kya hota hai? We have a K2SO4 molecule. Right, isn't it K and SO4 minus are attached? Right, and this is a additional compound. Right, this aluminium is associated with SO4 also. So you'll have that structure you can draw. KSO4, K2SO4 like this, K, SO4 2 minus. So we can draw this as, it's a salt, right? It will be 2K plus SO4 2 minus. It comes as a structure because of salt. So this K plus and SO4 minus, all these ions are present. See, actually 2 and 3 plus 3, SO4 2 minus, like this again. In the solution, we have all these ions present. Means, how do you get this? You have water. Water may you K2SO4 you dissolve, Al2SO4 you dissolve. The entire thing is this. This is not one structure you can draw. It's a salt.
Why do you say 24H2? Why not more or less?
It's hydrated form of this. Okay. So for aluminium, again, if you talk about this and this, we can take and this we can take. So here we have the coordination number of this and the coordination number of this. Total, the water molecule is coming out to be 24H2. Okay. That's why it is 24H2. It is the general form actually of alum. We can also call it as it is a potassium and aluminium salt of this. Potassium and aluminium sulfate salt of is nothing but the alum, right? So in this you write down, it is a double salt in which we have two different metals here, potassium and aluminium. Okay, like for this compound the name is potash alum. It's called potash alum because potassium is there. Potash alum. We can also take here chromium. Instead of aluminium, we can also write chromium. That is chrome alum. So alum is a general name. Okay, potash alum and chrome alum. Next write down. It is prepared from bauxite ore. It is prepared from bauxite ore. What is the formula of bauxite?
A2O2H2O.
So, right on. Bauxite is heated with or boiled with H2SO4 to form aluminium sulfate, Al2SO4 both sides.
With
concentrated H2SO4.
Concentrated
H2SO4. H2SO4 forms aluminium sulfate, in which K2SO4 is added, and the resulting solution is concentrated in. So the reaction is Al2O3 with H2SO4. It forms Al2SO4 whole thrice and H2O. Now in this we add K2SO4 and the entire thing will result in gold. You get A2SO4 dot Al2SO4 whole thrice 24H2O. This is nothing but potash alum, or simply we call it as alum. Okay, property write down is a white crystalline compound. It is soluble in water. It is soluble in water and its aqueous solution. And its aqueous solution is acidic in nature. Why? Because this part, Al2SO4 whole thrice, this goes under hydrolysis into this. Okay? Soluble in water and its aqueous solution is acidic in nature. So acidic, why? Because this Al2SO4 whole thrice reacts with water, forms AlOH whole thrice and H2SO4. That's why the solution becomes acidic. Okay? Write down on heating at 200 degrees Celsius, it eliminates water molecule. So it forms K2SO4 dot Al2SO4 whole thrice and 24H2O. On red heat, further if you heat this compound, it converts into K2SO4. On red heat forms K2SO4 and Al2SO4 dissociates into Al2O3 and SO4. You can simply write this as Al2SO4 also. Right? Next, write down carbon family. What are elements we have? Carbon atomic number is 4. 1 is 2. 2 is 2. Oh. 1 is 2. 2 is 2. 2B2. So general outermost electronic configuration is NH2 and NB2. I'm going a bit quick here. NH2, NB2, there are 4 electrons in the outermost shell, so it can show plus 2 and plus 4 oxidation state. The possible oxidation state is this. Again, the general trend is, as we go down the group, then atomic radius increases, metallic character also increases down the group. As ionization energy decreases. Write down the next thing, ionization enthalpy. Write down. The first ionization enthalpy. The first ionization enthalpy of the elements of group 40. First ionization enthalpy of the elements of group 14 is higher than to that of higher than to that of the elements of group 13. What about atomic radius? 13 and 14? 13 is more. Why? 14. Effective nuclear charge. Effective nuclear charge. Okay. So ionization in terms of group 14 elements is more than to that of group 13 because of lesser size, more effective nuclear charge. Down the group, if you go, the order is this: carbon, silicon, germanium, and after this we have lead and then tin. Okay, this is the change we have here. And why this change is there? Because of again F of shell, right? So we'll have what? Greater attraction towards the nucleus. And hence the difficult to remove electron. Okay, that is the change in electronegativity. Down the group you go, electronegativity decreases. Write down next one, oxidation state. These elements can show plus 2 and plus 4 oxidation state. Elements with plus 4 oxidation state. Elements with plus 4 oxidation state behaves as oxidizing agent, and with plus 2 it is reducing agent. Same thing, inert pair effect, the stability of plus 4 oxidation state decreases down the. That's why plus 4 has tendency to convert into plus 2. So get reduced, oxidize others, right? Write down the stability of plus 4 oxidation state decreases down the group. Plus 4 oxidation state decreases down the group, and that of plus 2 oxidation state increases down the group. Plus 2 oxidation state increases down the group and plus 4 decreases. The reason is inert pair effect. Write down general characteristics of the compounds of group 14 elements. General characteristics of the compounds of group 14 elements. Okay, the first one, is hydrides. Okay, hydrides. Group 14 elements, we know it forms covalent hydrides. Okay, hydrogen, we have discussed it, right? Last class only. That group, first two elements, like group boron forms electron deficient hydrides, boron family. No. Carbon forms electron precise hydrides. And all the other groups form electron rich hydrides. Okay, so write down the elements of this group forms covalent hydrides of MH4 type. We all know it generally forms four types of compounds, that is paraffins, which is alkane, olefins, which is alkene, and acetylene, which is alkyne. And apart from that, we have aromatic compounds also. So all four compounds, carbon forms with hydrogen. Okay. So next, write down alkenes. Write down alkenes has a weak pi bond. A weak pi bond, hence it can show addition reaction. Addition reaction and more reactive also, we can say. More reactive in comparison to alkane. More reactive in comparison to alkane.